students, welcome to another session of CoJava tutorials. So we'll see relational operators today. In the previous videos, I have covered arithmetic and bitwise operators. Now we'll see relational operators. There are four kinds of relational operators. They are greater than, or equal to, less than or equal to. Okay, so these relational operators are used to determine the relationship between two operands. Okay, so I am saying two operands because they cannot be used on more than two operands. Like nesting of the operators is not allowed. So we'll see all that in the rules that I have given here, how to use this relational operators. The first one is like only, they can be applied only on numerical types. What are the numerical types? Those are int types, float types, and then char. Okay, so these operators can be applied only on numerical types. And the next one is the outcome of this operation. Okay, so say I'm saying A is greater than B or whatever, the outcome is a Boolean type. Okay, so if A is greater than B, if this is true, then the result will be of Boolean type, because Boolean only will be holding true or false. So the outcome will be only of Boolean type. And the next one is like these relational operators will be used in expressions that control if statements, for and while. Okay, so generally they are used in if, for and while. And next one is nesting of the operators. Nesting of relational operators is not allowed. Like I cannot say A is less than B is less than C and all that. This is not allowed. I cannot nest it, because why it is not allowed is its simple logic that A is less than B will be either it can be true or false. So this will be evaluated true. And I cannot say true is less than C. There is no meaning to that. So that's the reason nesting of operators is not allowed. And this cannot be applied on objects. You cannot compare or compare two objects. You can compare the values of the objects, like the members of the class, but you cannot compare the objects. Okay, so you cannot apply these operations on the objects. We'll see certain examples. Okay, so the examples are like I'm saying int A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 20. So I want to compare whether A is greater than B or less than B or whatever. So since the result is of Boolean type, I'm saying Boolean R is equal to A is greater than B. So if I try to print R, what will be the value of R? The value of R will be false, because A is greater than B evaluated to false because A is less than B. Okay, so it is false. And coming to the next one, I can use it in if, while and for, like this. Okay, so I can say if A is less than or equal to B, this is absolutely correct. And I can say A is greater than or equal to B. Okay, so I want to know it. Okay, so then while A is, this is how you can use it in if, while and for and all that. Okay, so they are used in expressions that control statements, if statements and loops. And I can also use them in system.out.println. For the people who have come from C and C++ background, this is like in C we use printf statement, this is like that. And in C++ we will be using cout statement, it is just like that. And this will print whatever I give it in this parenthesis, this will print these things on the console output screen. Okay, so that's the purpose of system.out.println, and I can use this relational operators inside them. So I can say 50 is greater than 40. Okay, so if 50 is greater than 40, what will it print on the screen? It will print true on the screen for me. Okay, and this is absolutely correct. And I can say, since I said that these can be applied on integers, floats and characters, I can also use it. This will be converted into integer type. Okay, so the value of A. Okay, so value of A, and then it will compare it to that. So the answer will be false, because A is greater than, the value of A in from Unicode is greater than 20. So the answer will be false. And capital A is less than 100.20. Okay, so here we are trying to compare it. A will be get converted to double, and then it will compare. And then it will become A is less than S. Of course, it will be less than. So it will be true. Okay, and I said system.out.println, true is greater than false. I want all of you to pause and guess the output of this particular statement. So this will not execute. Why it will not execute? Because I said it cannot be applied on Boolean types. Okay. I cannot also say true is greater than 20 like that. I can not do all this. Okay, so this is not possible. And these relational operators are also called as ordering operators. Okay, so they are also called as ordering operators. Okay, so that's it regarding relational operators. Now we will see equality operators. Okay, so there are two equality operators. The first one is equal to. So don't get confused between assignment and equal to. If you are using single equal to sign, this is called as assignment operator. But if you are using two, then only it is called as equal to. So this is one mistake generally students make. So I'm just emphasizing on this. Okay, so this is called as equality. Okay, so and this is not equal to. Okay, so these operators are also called as universal operators. Why did I say these two are universal operators? Is because they can be applied on all primitive data types. Okay, so on all primitive data types that Java supports, you can apply on them. That's the reason why I said they are universal operators. And not only that, they can be used to check the equality between the object references. Okay, so you can check between, they are also used for to check the equality between the object references. So these operators are very useful. So we'll just see how to put it in a program. Okay, so you can just, they are generally used for if, and they are also used in while, okay, and for and all that. So this is how you put them in the code. I can say if A is equal to B to check equality between these two operands. If both are equal, then the outcome will be Boolean type. Okay, so the outcome of the equality operators is Boolean. Okay, so this is the outcome. The result will be given in Boolean type. So if both are equal, then there will be, it will return true. For example, say A is 10 and B is also 10. Then what will be the output? The output will be true. Okay, so then some statements will be executed after the if block. Then A not equal to B. So say A is 10 and B is also 10. I am saying A not equal to B. So the outcome of this will be false. So equality will be evaluated like this. I can also use them in system.out.println like this. So I am saying lowercase a is equal to, I am checking equality between these two. Okay, lowercase a is 97 in Unicode. So what will be the output of this? It will be true. Okay, so I can also check equality between Boolean. Remember what I said? They are called as universal operators. You can apply them on all primitive data types. So true is equal to true. So the outcome will be true. So this is possible with the equality operators. And one thing I told you is that you can also check equality between object references. This is how you create an object, okay? And that object is referred by this particular variable. Okay, so this is object reference. And also, I am having another object created over here, and that is pointed out by B. And now I am making C and A equal over here. So now we'll see whether you can compare the object references or not. A, B, C are the object references. And I'm trying to compare them. I'm saying A is equal to C or not. So this is totally valid. And since A and C are pointing to the same object. Okay, so A and C both are pointing to the same object. So this will return true for you. And since A and B are pointing to two different objects. Okay, so this is B pointing to different object over here. So that's the reason the answer over here will be false. This is very, very important interview question for you. Okay, so this is all regarding relational and equality operators. Hope this video is worth watching. Stay home, stay safe, happy learning. Bye.